shit. Tell me what the fuck you want to say to my face. I'm going to be and I'll be mad.
Dave Palumbo here with an RxMuscle news update. Word out of Dubai is that there was a clash of the titans between internet sensation Luimarco and William Bonac. The last time we reported something like this, it was Rich Piana and Mack Truck squaring off at the LA Fit Expo. Not so this time, but now we're out in the Middle East, in Dubai, and Luimarco was at a booth where he was interviewing people. And I gotta just stop for a second because, you know, sometimes I've been critical of some of these social media guys on YouTube, and I gotta say, Luimarco has stepped up to the plate. He's been going out to shows, covering stuff. Now, granted, I'm sure he's being flown out there by promoters and stuff like that because he's got a tremendous social media following, but hey, I take my hat off to him. He built it from the ground up himself. But what he's found out is once you go to these shows and you put your face out there and you're not hiding in your house, it becomes a little more dangerous when you criticize people because now some of these people who take things personally will come up and, you know, address you.
You insulted me. You insulted me. Yeah? You insulted me. You should be. Listen, I'm going to tell you once this. If you ever want to say shit to me,
I had Flex Wheeler, who was very angry at a show. Not that nothing that I had said, but something someone who I had on my show had said about him, and he confronted me in Germany, and I had a report on that. So it wasn't a physical altercation, but I think that this one between Bonac and Luimarco could have certainly gotten heated to the point where punches were thrown, at least on William Bonac's part. What happened? What went on? Well, you know, there's a lot of speculation. First off, you know, Luimarco obviously is very good friends with Beta Badai, who obviously likes to use Luimarco as his propaganda machine for his athletes, which is fine. Louis gets, you know, the royal treatment from Beta. He gets flown out there and treated well. He gets the breaking stories first. So it's kind of like, Beta is almost like a Steve Blackman in the sense, although he pays. And he has his athletes who wants coverage, and Luimarco is his media outlet that he usually uses, you know, and he sends people to us too. So Luimarco has been obviously doing coverage of athletes and shows, and so he decided to show up at the Dubai Fitness Expo. And I guess William Bonac, from what I hear, who actually works for, I guess, one of Bader's in Kuwait nemesis, you know, there, you know, one of the guys who works for another organization, runs shows in another organization, and I don't know what William's arrangement with him is, but he obviously does stuff for him. And so they're two separate camps, and they do clash on their ideals. And I thought initially that could have been the problem, but if you listen to the video that has been released, some of it by Luimarco, what went on at the booth there, it seems as though Bonac is pissed off at something or some criticism that Louis made about some pictures of his. Now, it's interesting because William Bonac just placed third at the Mr. Olympia contest just recently, a couple months ago. And a lot of people, myself included, thought he should have been second. As much as I love Big Rami's physique and the size he brings to the table, I thought that Bonac was a much more refined athlete on that day. He pretty much came in flawless. I mean, his only flaw was maybe being too short, and you know, nothing he can control about that. He pretty much brought awesome conditioning. He filled out his physique. His presentation was great. You know, he's got a lot of confidence. You know, some people may see it as cocky, but I see it as confidence on stage, and I think that's a, you know, you have to have that eye of the tiger, so to speak, up there if you want to really, you know, win shows. And I'm sure Bonac was pissed off. A lot of people thought he should have won the Olympia. I don't think he should have beat Heath, but I certainly think he should have beat Rami. And I know Luimarco is a big, big Rami fan, of course, because he covers, you know, Beto Badai's athletes. And, you know, look, it's hard not to like Rami. He's got so much muscle. And I don't know if that had anything to do with it. Maybe Louis was a little too critical of Bonac because of the fact that maybe he had a little bit of favoritism towards Big Rami. And Bonac obviously didn't like it, or something was said. And we're gonna get some in the coming days, some more insight from both Louis and from Bonac, and find out exactly what went on. But the bottom line is that Bonac, you know, was verbally abusive to Luimarco. He looked like he would have gotten physical had people not gotten in there and broken it up. And, you know, look, we're in a sport which is already demonized by the public already. We have a magnifying glass over our head, and we're thought to be guys that have roid rage, you know, to begin with. So it probably wasn't a good idea to be, you know, assaulting someone, or at least verbally assaulting them in public. Now, if Bonac had no intention of escalating that any further, then, you know, that's fine. I think verbal assault is fine, you know. If he wants to voice his opinion, fine, as long as it wasn't going to get to a point of physical altercation, because that's not acceptable. You don't lay your hands on someone unless, you know, they're doing something very dangerous to you and you're defending yourself, because in this day and age, first of all, you go to jail, especially in the Middle East, you know, you don't do it in a country that's foreign to where you're from. Secondly, you just don't do that. It's not the right thing to do, not savages. So I would have liked to see them work it out in a better way. Obviously, it added excitement to our industry. It's something to report on, you know. Luimarco obviously is very critical of a lot of people, and there's going to be people out there that don't like that. And if you're going to go to shows, Louis, and you're going to, you know, put yourself out there, you better be prepared to answer to these people. Because I've criticized people just, you know, in contest prep, and people get upset sometimes about that. So, and he, you know, he acts as though he's above the law, in the sense that he doesn't ever feel he's ever going to encounter these people, which he never did in the past. And so he was able to pretty much say whatever he wanted. Now, you got to be careful. You know, you have to really be able to word things in such a way that you're not insulting the people. You can criticize their physique, but you can't be insulting, because now people are going to come back at you, and you're going to have to answer to them. And if it doesn't bother you that they're going to be yelling and screaming in your face and threatening you, then great. But, you know, at least when I try to criticize people or critique them, I try to do it in a bodybuilding fashion, not in a personal way. Not to insult their character or what they may do, or, you know, the bubble gut thing is a little insulting, you know, when it's constantly. I mean, even Phil Heath, who's got very thin skin, just, you know, couldn't take it after a while and had to tell off Luimarco. So, you know, when you have a social media following like Louis does, these things are going to happen, you know. And the funny thing was, if you listen to the end of the video, I don't know if you can hear it, Luimarco's like, "You'll never place top six again." And which I thought was funny, because Bonac is certainly a clear top six, not if not top three, Olympian for years to come, probably. And he's only improving. So that was probably just his way of, you know, look, when you get assaulted like that verbally, you want to say something back to make the person feel bad about themselves. And I guess that's the only thing that he could think of. But I'd love to hear Luimarco's insight into what happened, because he probably has better insight. And I'm sure we'll get a video from him in the next couple of days about why this happened and what the story was. And maybe we'll even get him on RxMuscle.com to give his story. And I'd love to get Bonac's story as well, because it is interesting. You know, you don't see this much very often. Back in the 80s and 90s, guys would get into fistfights backstage, but you'd never see it. You very, very rarely saw it in an expo. You would see it like in the locker room. You know, the athletes would report, "Oh, Mike Quinn punched this guy out," or "so-and-so did this," or, you know, but you didn't, Mike Matarazzo threatened this guy. But you never really saw it. You know, probably the closest thing to that would be Craig Titus sucker punching, you know, Arnie List at Gold's Gym Venice back in the day. So what happened? I'm sure we're going to find out the full details in the next couple days. I just want to give you guys the update. Dave Palumbo here with another RX Muscle News update.